run far away from Halloween 2, the latest installment of writer-director Rob Zombie's version of unstoppable killer Michael Myers. In Halloween 2, we witness the physical and psychological effects of the surviving victim from his first Halloween remake, Laurie Strode, yet you never really care about her. That's one of the biggest problems with this film. You never really identify with any of the characters or feel any shock or regret when they're dead. There are a couple of decent actors in this film, including Malcom McDowell as Dr. Loomis and Brad Dourif as the sheriff, but they both seem to be phoning in their parts. This is a horror film with lots of gore, but almost no suspense. To me, that's like having a PB&J sandwich without the jelly. Zombie's idea of chilling is to have Michael stab or smash his victims for several more times after they're already dead. Does getting stabbed 10 more times after you're dead hurt more or make it scarier? I don't think so. There's also a couple of wacky, unnecessary touches that don't help out the film. Two of the scenes were scored with 60s and 70s pop music, including 10cc's The Things We Do for Love and the Moody Blues' Nights in White Satin. I know Zombie's going for a little irony here, but it doesn't work. It's just goofy. There's also a subplot involving the spectral spirit of Michael's deceased mother and a ghostly white horse, which continually grinds the thin plot to a screeching halt. It's just silly, not scary. This film's not even in the same ballpark as the original Halloween, directed by John Carpenter, so do yourself a favor and rent the original instead of wasting your cash on this badly executed excuse of a horror film. I'm Keith Kelly.